speak up if you got a question. You'll just scare me half to death.
Yes,
one time I was doing this with a student. It was a calculus class. And all of the calculus, there was only like 5 or 6 students in the class on that day. And they were all sitting in one little area. And I was talking to them. And then this thing was turned up like real loud. And there was like the person Skyping in. There was 2 people Skyping in. And one of them had a question. They said, well, what about this, da, da, da? And I was trying to figure out, who in the heck was that? It scared me to death. And it was this the Skype. I forgot all about having the Skype on. This is an online student, Mr. Robertson. And anybody can Skype in. That's the way you do it. You just text me, and you let me know. Like if you're 9:30 class, then let me know about 9:35, because it takes me a few minutes to get out. Just say, I want to Skype in. And you can see everything I'm doing. Same thing as the video, only with this you can get attendance because you're actually Skyping in. You're in the class. You're just not physically in the class. And I'll figure it takes maybe a couple of months, and Tri-County Tech will say that this is not a true absence or a true being present. So just give them time before they, once teachers start using it, then they'll say, oh, well, that doesn't count. Just give it time. But anyway, that's another way you can get a present when you got a doctor's appointment or whatever the case may be. One thing I want to cover, and thanks to Mr. Harvale, I wanted to show y'all the page that he used to see if your computer. Remember when I told you that the computer will, some of y'all's computer will blow up here and try to do My Labs Plus. Well, you might want to go to this page before you do everything on your computer at home, because it has, this is what my math lab used to have. When you went on to My Math Lab, when you enrolled yourself, you could hit a button and it would check everything on your system. I don't know why. I don't know if my Labs Plus has it. I don't know if it doesn't have it. I haven't seen it. But it tells you about the systems that you use and tells you what to do if you have a Windows or a Mac. And it tells you how to check your computer right here. You just click on that right there. And it tells you, gives you updates on all of these search engines if you need that. So anything else it'll tell you, Mr. Harvale?
Yeah, it'll tell you if you need it, like I said, the update brochures.
Yep.
All those right there. It's a straightforward
help.
Right through it. And you don't leave anything out. You'll have to do some things because you've got to put things in.
Yeah. So go to this page. I sent it to everybody. You don't have to write it down. I sent it to everybody. And, of course, some people still break the anvil with a banana, but there'll be less people. Instead of 5 or 6 people, there'll probably be just one person breaking the anvil. But that's a good page to go to.
And that student support, that gives you a handbook on
right here.
Every screen you
want to
see.
Okay, good. So that's a good thing to go to. I'm glad. I appreciate you doing that. And I sent it to everybody. So you won't be able to break the anvil as bad, even though some people will still do it. Some people are still using those computers that come over on Mayflower. Anyway, that's that, and I think I sent out a couple of other things. Yes, I did. I sent out a thing about attendance, but that was for that's the 103 class. The 103 online class, I sent that out because there was a little bit, I'm trying to find it, a little bit of, okay, I know I sent that out. I sent a copy to myself. Now, where is it? Anyway, the Math 103 class, a couple of the students in the Math 103 online class got a little bit confused about the attendance because my handout is pretty much generic, and my handout is, I don't know where it went. Let me go to sent. trying to do two things at one time. That's why my mind's not working too good. Well, I guess I'm just crazy. I can't find stuff on this email like I used to, because they put everything under one thing and I lose it. So anyway, I sent out for the 103 online class, I sent out an email explaining that the handouts that I give y'all are mainly for conventional classes. Where? Right here? Right there. Thank you. There it is. It says, due to my handouts being generic and focused on conventional classes, that's what my handouts are, because 98% of my classes are conventional. I only teach an online class every once in a while and in the summer. Very rarely do I teach online classes. And all my handouts are targeted to conventional classes. But at Tri-County Tech, we have to take attendance in our online classes. How much sense does that make? So how do you take attendance on online classes? Well, they decided that we need to do attendance by participation, and that the teacher that teaches the online class has to somehow measure the participation of the student in the online class. So some teachers do different things. Some teachers, students do homework every week. They give out a homework assignment every week, and if they do that assignment, then they're present for that week. But that's too vague. So what I do is I do an online assessment at attendance quiz. And for the online students, they have to take that quiz. And it basically is what y'all's bonus questions are on your test. How does Hubert count his test? What's the percentages? Things like that. What branch did Hubert serve in? That kind of thing. Real easy questions. And they have to do it every Sunday, or by every Sunday at midnight. And that's how I take attendance in an online class. I think it's ridiculous. I think it's ridiculous to have mandatory attendance in a college. I think that's ridiculous. But just a peon teacher, I do what I'm told, and that's on that. One other thing I sent out, and that is, if I can find it, which I'm not very good at this, I sent out an email talking about the Skype and my YouTube page. Be looking for that also. If you don't check your email every other month, you need to start checking it, because especially in my class, I send out emails. So somewhere on there's something about YouTube and Skype for Business. Skype for Business and Skype is not the same thing. Skype is one-on-one. Skype for Business is for meetings, which means classroom. So if you own Skype, that's good, but you need to get Skype for Business. I told everybody, I showed everybody how to go to get Skype for Business. You go to the portal, the office portal. You type in hmcclure@tctc.edu, whatever your username at Tri-County. It will redirect you to the login, to the Tri-County login page. And once you type in your TCTC and your username TCTC@edu and your password, it will tell you to install. You can install up to 5 appliances, whether it be a computer or whether it be a tablet or a laptop or whatever the case may be. So therefore, you don't have the excuse, well, I don't have Office. And it'll update all the Office on your computer and all that good stuff. So I don't know if I showed y'all the other day. If I did, then great, but I'm going to show you again. Just go to the Office, just Google Office portal and sign into your account right there, and it'll take you right there. And when you type in, I don't know who I showed yesterday, I can't remember, or the other day, EDU, it'll redirect you and it'll take you to the Tri-County page, and then you type in the same thing that you do to check your email, and then boom, it'll have a little thing up here in the top right hand corner that says install, and then click install and it'll install everything, and then you have Skype for Business. You should. Sometimes you have to go down here. If you can't find it, type in Skype. It shows up right there. You click it, and then you can bring it over into your desktop. Okay, so that's how you get Skype for Business. On the YouTube page, that's pretty simple. I might have showed y'all. I can't remember. After the first week of class, I don't show any of this stuff. YouTube page, type in Hubert McClure. And you can go to the blue shirt and click on this different one, playlist, and y'all should be in here somewhere. There y'all are. That's the spring 2017 Math 103 in class and online. The online class is following the in-class test, in-class, the conventional class. I guess you can understand why I do that. That way I can make the video and give it to the online class or let them look at the video from the in-class. Therefore, I'm not doing double the what. You know, there's a thing in being lazy versus doing extra work. And there's no sense in doing extra work, you know, I'm going to make another set of videos for the online class. That's ridiculous. So that's how you find that. And, of course, the other day I forgot to turn on the look at desktop, and it just recorded my voice the other day, so I screwed that up. And that takes us to MyLabs Plus. Now, once you go to that page that Mr. Harbell was gracious to find and give to us, you should be able to go to your www.tctc.mylabsplus.com, and it should have MyLabs Plus for Tri-County Technical College. That's what it should have. And then you type in your username at Tri-County Tech. Let's spell my name. And then you type in, now the password for me, and I haven't ever changed it, is my T number. So if yours is a T number, then you might want to use the T number. If you've changed your password, and that is one of the biggest problems that we have with students. They changed their password two semesters ago, and guess what? They can't remember it. So that's why a lot of people use their T number, so they don't forget it. Okay? That's just something for you to think about. Okay? And the classes should come up like that. Now, mine is working, so yours should be working. If yours doesn't work, if you come up with a white screen, then you need to go to Mr. Harbell's page because your plugins. A white blank screen means that your plugins is not correct. Okay, that means that something's not working. If you pull up homework and it comes up a white blank screen or a whatever color blank screen and no numbers, that means your plugins are not right. So you need to fix that. Bless you. No more sneezing in class. And you click on to your 103, and you come to the main, they call it the dashboard, okay? There's the dashboard. When I assign a test or I assign homework, when I give you a start date and an end date, it will show up on this calendar. And some of y'all that's had MyLabs Plus before, it does that, okay? If I do not assign a date, a beginning and start date, then you don't need to worry about it. That's what the sheet says. Okay, but that's where it will be. The three tabs over here that you should know about. The homework section, and y'all are saying to yourself, I cannot believe he's going over the homework button. You would be surprised on how many emails I get. Have I said anything to you about Blackboard? No. Why? Because I don't use it. I don't use it because it's down all the time. Okay? The reason I don't use it is because everything is incorporated in MyLabs Plus. Yep, I'm going to use a lot of Blackboard. I'm going to do a lot of my assignments on Blackboard. So therefore, at the end of the semester, I have to transfer all those grades from Blackboard into MyLabs Plus because the gradebook is in MyLabs Plus. No, I don't think so. Now, if I was a conventional teacher, giving you handouts and stuff and giving you tests and giving everything, and then yes, I would probably use Blackboard because I would punch in the numbers there and use that gradebook. But since I'm giving you everything in MyLab Plus, it would be double the work for you and double the work for me to go to Blackboard. So, okay, everybody's got it. I don't use Blackboard, so don't go to Blackboard. Anyway, students that don't listen to me, they go to Blackboard and look for my assignments. Are my assignments on Blackboard? No. So that's why I have to tell everybody about the homework page, because I get an email, and either it says, I'm on Blackboard and I can't find your assignments, or they just leave Blackboard out and they say, I just can't find your assignments. I've been looking for 2 weeks. That is true. I still keep those emails in case anybody don't believe me. Okay? Click on homework. That takes you to the homework. Now, right now, it probably doesn't have any homework. It does. It's already open. Okay? So you can click on that, and I'll click on it in a minute, but that's the homework. We'll go over the homework in just a minute. Quizzes and tests. What do you think are in quizzes and tests? I don't know. Quizzes, where did I find your test? I don't know. It may be under grade book. I actually have gotten emails, and this is why this is a question on your test. Where do I find my grade? At the end of the semester, that's what I get. Where do I find my grade? That's what grade book is for. So the three most important things for you, there's four, but the three most important, homework, test, and grade book. Okay? At the end of the semester, after you have done everything, like right before the last day of finals, and you've already taken your final, you've taken your last test, you've finished all your homework, and you finished all your unit tests, that's when you get gradebook. And whatever gradebook says, that's your grade. Okay? As simple as that. You don't have to call me. You don't have to wait for Tri-County Tech to post their grades. You don't have to wait. If you want to know what you made in my math course, after you have finished everything, you click on gradebook and you check it. And whatever that thing says is true. Now, I'll do round up. 89.45 and above is an A. 79.45 is a B. 69.45 is a C. So if you make above a 65.49 or a 69.45, 79.45, 89.45, you get the next grade up. Okay? So that's that. That's now, what is chapter contents? Chapter contents is where you can pull up extra problems and you can pull up your text. Now, this answers the question, do I need a book? No, you do not need a book because the book is online. So this is where I tell students, if you want to buy a book, share a book, borrow a book, get a new book, get a used book, whatever the case may be. You do whatever you want to, because whenever you get into MyLab Plus, you actually have the book online. So a lot of students say, hey, wait a minute, I haven't opened my book yet. I want to save some money. Well, you can actually save about 30, 40, 50 bucks, whatever the case may be, and just get the access code online and use the book online. Okay, and you can print that out. I'll show you how to do that in just a minute. So that's something you might want to think about. Anyway, when you go pull up the chapter. We start in chapter, is it five? You go to chapter 5 and you pull up 5A. And when you pull up 5A, I don't know if we cover 5A or not, but I'm just using it. Section lecture video, it shows you a video on the whole section. Multimedia e-text. E-text is another way for writing book online. So you click on that, and if you turn to page, whatever page comes up, it's coming eventually. If you turn to page 286 in your book right now, you'll have this page right here. And it'll be the same page. If you want to print this page out, you go up to print, wherever it is, somewhere up here. Okay, it's not up there. There it is, thank you. I moved it. It used to be a little printer up here, now they moved it. And you can print up to 6 pages or 10 pages. Most of the sections in your book are about 10 pages or less, so that way they can make this generic 10 pages. And now you have to print out one at a time, but after you print it out, you put holes in it, put it in your notebook, and instead of carrying a book around, you just have to carry 4 or 5 sections. I think there's 6 sections in this unit one test. Okay, so you can do that. So now you can buy a book, share a book, borrow a book, use an old book, buy a new book, or print out your book and just use the access code. So there's 6 different ways, and I don't care which way you do. So that's how you print out the book. So remember, chapter contents. If you want to do extra problems, if you want to do extra problems, now does that count? No, extra problems is extra practice. If let's say we do 5A and you do the homework, but you want to do some more problems, then you click on study plan. And that'll take you to all the questions that they have for this 5A. Now let me explain what teachers do. Each teacher at Tri-County Tech, each full-time teacher, is assigned 2 or 3 classes to work on. My classes is college algebra and college trig. So when the book changes, I have to go into My Labs Plus and I have to pick out 15 to 25 questions for homework. I can't give you 50 because we don't want to give over 25 homework, okay? So I pick out the 20 to 25 questions that I think are important. If they don't have 25, then I pick 10, or whatever the case may be. I seldom, rarely give all of these because that's 30 or 40 questions right there. So I wouldn't give that. So if there was 10 to choose from, I would probably pick 5 or 6. For the homework. So what I'm trying to tell you is each book, each class, the teacher that's over the class does not pick all of the questions. So therefore, there's extra questions in the study plan that you've never seen before. Okay? Now some of these you will have seen in the homework because that's what they picked for the homework. But the other ones you haven't seen, so it's extra practice, and I would suggest it doesn't help your grade. Doesn't hurt your grade. It helps your grade to give you more practice. But as far as a numerical grade on the study plan, there is not one. It'll give you a grade. It'll say it's correct or not, but it will not put it in your grade calculation. Okay? So that way you can work on as many as you want to. It won't hurt or help your grade. Okay? Numerically, it won't. Now, for the actual questions, I'm going to grab one of these. I don't know what section this is. It's probably definitions. And, And it asks you, if to determine her blood sugar, Caroline divides up her day into 3 parts, morning, afternoon, and evening. She then measures her blood sugar level at 3 randomly selected times during each part of the day. At 3 randomly selected times. Okay. What type of sampling is this? Well, she's doing morning, afternoon, and evening. So that's, you might say, well, it says random, so I'm going to say random. Okay. And that's wrong because it's more stratified or systematic. It's not systematic, it's stratified, I think. And check answer. It says you suck. I would love to be able to program the things in here. Wouldn't you love to? You know, McDonald's is hiring. You should quit school. You're a failure. I would be fired the first week.
And you get it right. It's like, fantastic.
Yeah, I'd say, this was an easy question. You got it right. So what? Anyway, sorry, that's wrong. So you hit OK, and it gives you the chance to do it again. Where'd the thing go? It disappeared. Well, let me. Oh, there it is. Okay, say, she's doing it morning, noon, and afternoon, and evening. That's systematic. You push that and check answer. Oh, you got it wrong. Well, I thought it was systematic. No, it says right here, she measures her blood level at 3 what? Randomly selected. So it's not randomly sampled because you got morning, noon, and night here. And it's not systematic because she checks it random parts of the day. So it's not that. So you hit OK and you feel like a failure. But, huh? Yeah, but people aren't going to read it. Anyway, the next thing is to say, well, I've got two choices left. It's not a convenient sample because she's doing it morning, noon, and night. So I'd probably say stratified, which means grouping. And check answer, and you got it right, and you feel good about yourself. Next question. Well, let's say you go to the next question, and you have no earthly idea what the answer is. Crap, I got it right. Let me go to the next question. I just guessed at that one. All right, let's do this and hit A and check. Okay, that's wrong. And you say, well, darn it, that's right. I don't care what they say. And you get it wrong. And you get it wrong. Then they get tired of asking you. And you get an X beside that question. Well, let's go back. And we've got an X there. And you hit, where's a similar question? Okay, well, when you hit the similar question and you get it right, it turns this X into a check. So everybody should turn in what on your homework at the end of the semester? Will you? No. 23s, 2s, 7s, single digits for homework. Why? Because people are what? Can't get the word out. Lazy. They're lazy. Oh, I offended somebody. No, I didn't. It's just called what it is. If I give you a homework assignment and you don't do it, there's either you don't have a computer, which that's unacceptable because there's some downstairs. You can't work a mouse. That's unacceptable because everybody can work a mouse. You've been through K-12, you have to be able to work a mouse. You don't know how to do math, you wouldn't have graduated high school, and I think that's it. So that leaves one thing, you're lazy. And that's people that fail my classes, people that are lazy. So everybody should turn in 100 on their homework. If you ever meet anybody that failed my class, get away from them, quick. Because they're either lazy or very, very, they have issues. Let's just say that. And they might rub off on you if you're too close to them. You might catch lazy or catch stupid, one of the two. So get away from them. All right? So that's how you do that. Now, over here you got question help. Let me click on one of these. You got question help right here. And this is what I have to explain about these things because it's very important. Help me solve this. It doesn't have all of them. Oh, where did it get this? I got to go back and change that. Help me solve this as a guided tutorial. Okay? Or, no, it's not. Yeah, it is. It's got a tutorial. Help me solve this is, if you ever go to a tutoring lab and you have a tutor that asks you questions as you're doing a problem, that's what you call a guided tutorial. It's going to ask you questions as you do it. It's not going to just give you the answer. It's not going to just show you how to do the problem. The other icon that you'll see is called Show Me How to Do This. And Show Me How to Do This, or I think it says Show Me How to Solve This or whatever, it just shows you bit by bit by bit. It doesn't ask you anything. So the difference between those two things is one will ask you questions and the other will not. Okay, so some people like the second one because they don't want to have to go through an answer. This would drive me crazy. I could not stand having to ask questions while I'm trying to figure out what to do. So it can be kind of nerve-wracking to have to go through this, especially when you have 15 steps. And then they add another question in those 15 steps, and then you got 30 steps. So it can be nerve-wracking. So I think on some of the questions that have multi-steps, I think they actually give you the show me how to do this option so you don't have to go through this. All right, so that's the difference between help me solve this and show me. We'll see if we can find another one. For you visual learners, you got video or what's called a graphic tutorial. A graphic tutorial is basically a computer-generated video with a voice. And the video will come up and show you. The video is supposed to come up. Not having good luck this morning. And there it goes. Eventually. Hopefully. Okay, well, evidently the plugins are not good on this one. It worked last semester. I'm looking to see if it's moving. It's not even moving. Well, trust me, they work. I don't know why they're not working, but nothing is working for me this morning. There's the video. You're supposed to hit play, and it's supposed to work. Yeah. So, but I can't change it. I have to get IT to change it because it's frozen. Oh, well. I need to go to Mr. Harvell's doojigger. I can't change it, so I'll just leave it alone. And if you're a reader, hit the textbook, and it'll show you where to go in the textbook. It'll take you to the page, and it's right there. Okay? It also has print. Now, this is where you can print your homework assignment and actually do it at home and then come back and plug the answers into the computer. If you want to do it that way, that's fine. If you don't want to do it that way, that's fine too. But when you hit print, it's going to ask you, some of these teachers, it's supposed to ask you to print one, either this problem or print the whole assignment. So I'm going to have to go in and change that too. Anyway, this one is just going to print this. Now when I fix it, hold on a second. I understand some of these teachers. Shut up, Hubert. Let's see the sign up. What was that, 5A? Should be on there. It says it right there. Allow students to print this homework assignment. Okay, I don't think I'm having good luck today, period. Get out of that. I hit things and it don't work. Let's see this. Let me solve this. View an example. That's the one that shows you step by step. Okay, everything's on there. Why is it asking you to just do the whole assignment? Let me go back. Hold on a second. I was going to show you what I have to do. Let me just go to the settings and just do it. 5A. Edit. Oh, sorry. Edit. Okay. Whatever. Just go do what I asked you to do. Okay, everything's good. I was just checking to see if that one was allow students to print. Where is that? Yeah, right there. Well, I don't know why it's doing what it's doing, but it should when you
Let me go to the homework and see if it does it there. Homework. Whatever, just 5A. Why'd he take it out? All chapters. Oh my gosh. I ain't never had this much trouble. 5A. Oh, it's not assigned. Good gosh. I didn't hit anything about assigning, did I? I just hit save. Gracious God. Sometimes this thing can be very. Yeah. Homework. Now it should say 5A. Thank you. I appreciate it. Can I be in charge for a while? And click on here. Question help. Print. Thank you. Print homework assignment, and you can print the whole homework assignment. Now, the only thing I wanted to tell you is some people print the homework assignment, they go home, and a week later, after they've played on here a while, they change the questions. Don't do that. If you print the homework assignment out, go home, do it. Don't go back into the homework assignment and play with it, because it's going to change what? It's going to change the questions. So don't do that. What I tell students to do is print out the section of homework, go home, do it, then come back to the homework in the computer and punch in the answers. The questions have not changed. Okay? Some people try to have their cake and eat it too. They do want to do the homework on paper, and then they want to play with it while they're doing the homework on paper, and that don't work too well. Okay? And that's print this equation. Now, when you go up here, there's the help me, there's the view an example. View an example, it just tells you how to do it. It doesn't ask you any questions. That's it. So that's the difference between help me solve this and view an example. The only other thing is this one. And this is the one I want you to use when you either want to send me a question to do online or you want me to do it in class, whichever you want to do. If you send me a question and we meet tomorrow, then I'm not going to do it online unless you ask me. Now, if you send it to me at 9 o'clock at night and you want me to do it, then I will. But most of the time, if you have to have it at that moment, then send me a note, just ask my instructor, and right here, put off your lazy butt and show me how to do these. I do this for a reason, all right? And you hit send. Now, when I go to my Tri-County Tech email, it just has sent that because if you look, that's why I did a little message. Show you I didn't send it like yesterday or something. All right, send it that moment. And when I click on it, it'll take me right to your question and I don't have to go look it up. Eventually, it pulls it up. There it is. It's the same exact question. Now, this is great for students that don't want to ask questions in class. Utilize it, because what I do is I have folders over here. You see these folders? Math 103, Math 110, Math 120, Math 155. In fact, I need to go in and delete those. It probably said it knows something else. Anyway, I need to delete that. What do you delete on this stupid thing? There it is. Usually you have an X beside if you want to delete it. Good gosh. Anyway, I put them in there, and before I go over class the next day, and for the 103 online class, this is even better because they'll send me theirs and you'll send me yours, and in some cases, I'll be the both classes will get double the questions. In other words, it kind of helps to have two classes in one because you may ask this question, but somebody else may in the online class may ask another question, and it might help you out. So it kind of works. It's kind of nice to have two classes. So for the online class, you would send those questions in, and I would put them in the folder with the conventional class, and we'd go over them and video it, and I'd post it the next day, which would be, in this case, today is going to be called Second Day Math 103, which is going over all this stuff. Okay? So that'll work out real good. Now, back to homework. Back to here, what if you want to print out your test? Well, when you want to print out your test, you go to the grade book. Your grade book, not my grade book. You won't see this down here. Your grade book. And click on, if this was a test, you click on section 5A and you'd review it. Okay? Since I haven't done any of it, it says you haven't done anything. So, but when you do a test, it'll ask you to review it. There'll be a little hyperlink out here that says review. And when you hit that review button, you're basically going back into your test, and you'll have an option to what? To print. And then you can print that one. Now, what I tell students to do is to print each one of your tests with the highest grade, because my final exam is made up of those tests. So to study for the final exam that's online, you study your online what? Test. You don't study your lowest grade. You study the highest grade. Get it? Okay? I had one student that print out all the tests. So they had, instead of going over 4 tests, they were going over 12 tests. Because I give like 3 tries for each test. They printed out each one of them. Which some people would say that's pretty good. You get different questions, but it's a lot of extra work if you ask me. But 12 tests versus 4. It's a lot of confusion to go in there. Question on that. All right, who's got questions on anything having to do with MyLabs Plus? I need to go check something right quick, because the teachers that do this, they change weights. Yep. Let me change that right now. Any? Oh, 60. Oh, 80. Let's save that. Okay. And your final exam ends up to be 20% when I get through with everything. It comes out to be 20 because there's 5 tests. 5 tests is 20, 20, 20, 20 for 100%. And that 100%, you take 80% of that, and that is your test grade, and then this fills in the rest. Okay? Any questions on that? Anything I don't cover, I will take out of the homework. That's why you do not go ahead. All right? So if I'm on, now right now, I told you to do chapter 5, do it. Okay? But later on, when we're not doing a lot of reading, we're doing math, if I don't want you to go over 6.8, then don't do 6.8. Okay, don't go ahead of me when we get into the math, because sometimes I'll skip stuff. And I'll skip stuff I don't want to hear. I've already done it. Well, I didn't tell you to do it. You did it. So don't do that. Now, when I tell you to read, read all you want to, because there's no harm, no foul with reading. But I don't want you to do work and not get credit for it. So do not go ahead of me on the math portions, which means chapter 6. Don't go ahead of them unless you just want to do extra work. There's only about 3 or 4 sections I cut out of this book. Not much. Now, in the 120, I cut out several sections. And I try to cut out the whole last unit for this class. But sometimes I've got more time and I have to. So I'll try to drag it out where we can skip the last unit. But anyway, anybody got any questions? Nobody's got any questions? Advice on what?
On the homework?
Mm-hmm.
Or quizzes with who you give instructions to go for.
Oh, yeah.
Because I got to it, and I read it, and I was like, which is the sound up to the next 10. Well, I was putting it up in the spreadsheet.
Yeah.
And of course, marked it wrong. Even though I tried to do a similar question, it still had the X on it.
So what was wrong?
I was doing it at 16.16 something, and instead of doing 16.2 or whatever, I did 16.1 or 1.7 or whatever.
It was supposed to be 16.2.
Or something to that. Yeah. Something to that effect.
Okay, that leads me to your question leads me to two things that I need to cover. One is challenge questions. What is a challenge question? A challenge question is, let's say that you do a problem on a test and it says find the blah blah blah, find the blah 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 blah, and you put 0.5, and the question is you check your answers, you turn your test in online, and it comes back that you missed it and it has one half out there. Well, unless the question specifies a fraction or a decimal, I will grant you that answer. I will semi give you credit for 16.17 versus 16.2, because most of the time those questions do have the instructions to round to the nearest tenth. But what happens is the student does not round correctly when they do their calculations, or the spreadsheet rounds. So what I would suggest you do, if you use the spreadsheet or you use your calculator, to go ahead and fixate all the cells before you start at 10 digits or 5 digits or whatever. Because most of the time, they're going to tell you to round to the 10th or the 100th. Most of the time. Very seldom do they raise to the, they do say raise to the nearest whole number when we're talking about sample spaces. In other words, how many people do you need to survey to get a 95% confidence level? Well, people don't come in fractions. So you round up. If it's 252.2, you round up to 253. If it's 255.8, you round up to 256. And in some applications of math, you round up to make sure, mainly in statistics and engineering. Okay, because if you want a tensile strength of I-beam to hold up 31 people, you want to round up to 40 people, because you don't want the build, you don't want the floor to collapse. Okay, you always overestimate when you're talking about sample spaces and engineering. So when you use your calculator and your spreadsheet, which I do a lot of spreadsheeting, make sure all the cells are at 10 digits. Then when you get your last number of 10 digits, the final answer, that's where you round. You see, what happens is people use the calculator or the spreadsheet, and it's already set at 2 significant digits, meaning the second, the hundredths level, the hundredths place. And they don't check their calculator, and it's at 2 digits. And what happens is the calculator is, or the spreadsheet is rounding all the calculations to 2 digits. And when you get to the final answer, it's in 2 digits, and that's not the true 2 digits. It's supposed to be like 10 digits. You may be a digit off there, which brings you a digit off with the final answer. So that would be a problem there. So make sure when you do your calculations in statistics, probability and statistics, that all of your cells or your calculator is set to 5 or more digits, because they're going to ask you to round to the tenths or the hundredths. If they ask you to round to the thousandths, I'd tell you to carry 6 to 10 digits, or so to so, you know, so forth. Make sure you have a couple of digits buffer before you round. Okay? So thank you for that, because that leads me to challenge questions on homework and tests. Okay? If it's legitimate. Now, what if you have 62.51 and the question tells you to round to the tenth, and you put 62.51, and you get it wrong, 62.5. Well, I'll give you like half credit. The reason I have to give you half credit is because you didn't follow what? Directions. Now, in her case, she had 62.17, and it was 62.7 or 62.2. In that case, she gave me more digits. I have to weigh each one, okay? I'm not going to, you know, you have to tell me what you did. And if you tell me that you, truthfully, if you tell me that you did it on the spreadsheet and didn't set it, then I'll give you a little bit more credit. But I have to be very careful there because some people will take advantage of me there. And I just have to watch it. So try to follow directions whenever you can. And remember to set your calculator and your spreadsheet to 5 more digits, okay? Yep. All right, anybody else got a question or input? Anybody got questions or input about the class since you've had 48 hours to think about the class or anything? How is your other classes? Got any people that know everything in the other classes? Yeah, oh, psychology and nursing is real bad besides my psychology. You know, Barney Fife on the Andy Griffith Show, he would read an article in a magazine about psychology, and he would know everything there is about psychology. Well, we got people like that that take psychology and try to tell the teacher how to do things. Those are your NASA engineers. Those are the people that you avoid. You run into the women's restroom and you're a guy because you don't want to see that person. You don't want to talk to them. Those are the people you try to avoid.
I don't know. I was looking around here to make sure there wasn't nobody in here from the class. But my anatomy team class, oh my gosh, this has got to come out of here. First of all, I don't know why he's in there. He's so daggone smart. He's taking his stuff home somewhere. Because he works for the ambulance people.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Now we're talking about something totally different. We're talking about EMT Superman.
Yeah. But.
Does he wear his uniform to class? Does he wear his uniform to class?
He does. And he managed to tell us, I taught like 2 years of high school anatomy and this and that. So the whole time we're going over stuff, he's over here. So do you mean this? Do you mean this?
Those are the people you run from because they have some kind of short complex.
Well, it ain't going to be much longer, and I'm going to turn around and ask him to weekly shut up.
Thank you. That's what more students need to do.
Because I can't with her.
You can't concentrate, and it intimidates you. It makes an uncomfortable environment.
Exactly. My teacher can already talk fast, and I kind of have to slow down.
Who do you have for a teacher?
Heather Erlingham. She's good. She just, I've heard lots of things about her, but for me, I can already tell my issue's going to be following her. She's a little bit too fast for me. But she talked.
Let me go ahead and tell you. Anatomy and physiology. There is no slow course. I see students, and this is no joke, I see students in the lobby every semester, and they're just, the whole class is down there in the lobby, and they're just like this. They're like that.
It's not serious. I mean, this is 2:11, so I already took two. Oh, okay. But it's just like, with her, she talks quickly. Her talking speed is so fast.
That, I would suggest you getting a recorder and maybe slowing it down to like the Charlie Brown teacher. But to talk about what you're talking about, the ones that I've seen are the nursing assistants students. Mm-hmm. They've been a nursing assistant for 115 years, and they had to go back to school to get their degree because they're fixing to get fired, and they're trying to tell everybody how to do everything because they've been a nursing assistant for 125 years. So it's the same thing, but see, it's worse because I've got some friends that are EMTs, and they are the greatest people in the world. But you got your Barney Fifes in EMTs, you got your Barney Fifes in volunteer firemen, and you got your policeman Barney Fifes, and they ruin it for everybody else. The 10% Barney Fife syndrome, they ruin it for everybody. So you just have to, you just have to ignore him until it gets to a point where you either say something to the instructor. Or if the instructor don't do anything after you say something to the instructor, then you need to say something and say, please be quiet. You're making this an uncomfortable environment. That's all you need to do.
That's kind of where I'm at. I mean, I would be respectful, but I'm
not going
to sit back behind me and talk
off
class. Please.
It does get on your nerves. You got one too? In what class?
But I don't think what happens
when he read an article, I bet.
He thinks it's all paper.
Oh. Okay, I'm going to get a degree in psychology. Okay.
For the record, I'm going to swear to you by your dreams, but I would for a year, after me, and I'm going to go ahead and let you know. Unless you have a doctorate in psychology, you can't do anything
with it. I know. You got to be a psychiatrist or something like that, or what do you call it, a psychotherapist, something like that. There's a lot of horror movies with psychotherapists in it. Gets into your brain and stuff.
That's what I meant.
So, all right, any other questions? All right. So everybody next week is going to be on My Lab Plus. Everybody for Monday is going to have, that's when we meet next, right? Everybody's going to have chapter 5. Huh? Oh, we got a holiday. Okay, so Wednesday. Wednesday, that gives you 2 more days to get logged on and to get chapter 5 read. And Monday we'll go through chapter 5 and I'll pick out all, so bring your highlighters or bring your notebook to write down the words that I'm going to highlight or whatever you bring attention to. And if you got any questions for me, Mr. Robertson, are you still good?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you got any questions?
Not that I can think of right now.
He fell asleep. Do you have any questions, Mr. Robertson?
No, sir.
Okay. All right, no questions here. Y'all get out of here, and I gotta give you a here for the day. Okay. Mr. Robertson, I'm gonna cut you off.
All right. Have a good one.
Have a good one.